same time.
And if there's lightning outside, I'm inside.
Lightning is nature's most deadly weather event. It kills 100 to 200 Americans every year. More in the average year than all the deaths in hurricanes, tornadoes, and floods combined. As this unedited videotape shows, no other act of nature can match its swiftness, beauty, or its frequency. Lightning strikes in the United States some 14 million times a year.
Oh, this is simply awesome. You can almost see by this lightning.
And while its beauty can be truly awesome, its power can be deadly. I'm Tom Skilling. It's nature's biggest spark. All of us have shuddered at one time or another as lightning has ripped through the air, and we've wondered, how safe are we? Tonight, we'll tell you how you can protect yourself from lightning. We'll introduce you to scientists who are creating lightning in order to study it. The films they produced are remarkable. You'll meet pilots who deliberately seek out lightning strikes as cameras roll. We'll tell you about new research which seems to link lightning with some super tornadoes, like the one which devastated Plainfield. And we'll also talk to those who have been hit by lightning and live to tell about it. May 1991. A storm like this one moves across a playing field in Washington, D.C., where St. Albans School is playing a championship lacrosse game. Suddenly, a lightning bolt flashes off a tree, striking a group of players. One youngster is killed, 15 are injured.
There was a big boom, and then, like, for me, everything turned orange and then black, and then everybody's running, and the people behind me by the trees, like five of them, were on the ground.
Susan Trudeau and her family know firsthand the terror of a lightning strike. They were huddled under an umbrella in a parking lot in their apartment complex in West Suburban Woodridge when they were struck by lightning. Susan was severely injured.
I lost my eardrum in my right ear. It has since been replaced, but my hearing is pretty much gone in that ear. I had a shattered jaw. I had burns all over my body. The worst injury was to my heart. I was in heart failure, and it wasn't beating on its own. They had to keep it going with drugs.
She required high doses of medication and other mechanical support for her heart for several days.
The fearsome elements of lightning are heat and current. In an instant, a single lightning stroke heats a channel of air to 50,000 degrees. That's five times hotter than the surface of the sun. The current from a single lightning bolt could power 100,000 light bulbs. The combination of heat and current can have dire consequences for anyone caught in lightning's path.
Why don't you call the surgical attending for the month and discuss it with them and see if we could get her in clinic?
Dr. Marianne Cooper of the University of Illinois at Chicago is recognized around the world as an expert on lightning and its effects on the human body. She has treated hundreds of lightning strike victims.
They don't become a crispy critter or go up in flames or disintegrate into a little pile of dust. No, generally they have a cardiac arrest, and that's what causes the death.
We got two guys that were struck by lightning, but
oddly enough, most people hit by lightning survive. These two men were hunting in Southern California when they were struck by lightning as they stood under a tree. Like many lightning victims, they're alive because they didn't take a direct hit.
Looks like the lightning started up here, probably bounced from the tree to his head, and all the way down his body. You can see where it shredded his pants. Totally shredded these pants here.
Does he need an IV or anything?
Did it come out there?
And then came out his foot. You can see this line of the lightning going down. There's the electricity going down his foot. And it looks like it went out his toenail here. Here's his boot. Hole right through the boot, you can see. And then this is what happened inside his foot. And it looks like it went out through his toe, through the boot. Just exploded right through the boot.
Do you think this man's lucky?
He's very lucky, probably because it hit the tree first and then, divided, so he didn't get the full lightning bolt.
Remember anything about it?
Scared the hell out of me.
Lightning, instead of going through the individual, tends to flash over the outside most of the time of a human being, turns the steam or turns the rainwater or sweat into steam, blows the clothes off. I've seen the tennis shoes and socks completely blown off from this.
What's really frightening is thunderstorms don't have to be directly overhead for lightning to strike. These storm chasers are about to encounter lightning. Notice the patches of blue sky overhead.
Oh, my God!
Oh,
right in the video! My God!
This is called anvil lightning. This lightning stroke has arced miles ahead of the thunderstorm which produced it into a rain-free area under the storm's anvil cloud. It was this type of lightning which tragically took the life of 17-year-old Jeff Richards of North Suburban Skokie. He was standing on second base during a baseball game when he was struck and killed by lightning, even though the skies directly above him were blue.
I saw a red light come down, like a red bolt of light just come down and hit him. I saw it split his hat, and it hit me, and it split my, it sent a shock right through my body. And then I looked up and he fell backwards, holding together like this, and it just scared me real bad.
Lightning strike victims can also be injured in ways that doctors don't completely understand. Harold Deal was struck by lightning in 1969. Since then, he rarely feels the cold. In fact, he can be seen shoveling snow in sub-zero temperatures, wearing only a pair of overalls and a t-shirt.
I do not feel cold. Since 1969, I have never as much as wore a long sleeve shirt in sub-zero weather. 20, 30 below zero, I have been out in chill index of 54 below for approximately 5 hours at one time, and my skin doesn't even turn red.
Doctors say they don't know why Harold doesn't feel cold anymore, and Harold says he receives stares from neighbors and curiosity seekers.
People will see me, it's not used to me. Hey, they'll ask people there at home, what about that guy out there in the no coat on? So I was, don't pay attention, that's just weird, Harold. And you can't believe how many out-of-state people has offered me jackets.
For many victims of lightning strikes, psychological scars often remain long after the physical damage heals.
Their friends may look at them funny as the human lightning rod or something like that. And because there's no external signs, they don't take the injury seriously, although the victim does. Nobody else seems to. And so you'll find the lightning victim pulling into themselves and becoming isolated for sometimes several years.
If you've had a car accident or any other kind of injury, fallen off a ladder or whatever else that has injured you badly, you usually can find other people to talk to that have been through the same thing or known somebody that's gone through the same thing, but you're alone. It's a very isolating experience.
The odds of being hit by lightning are incredibly small, 1 in 600,000 according to some estimates. But when lightning strikes and beats the odds, the shocking consequences can last a lifetime. Coming up, how scientists are studying lightning by creating their own lightning bolts.
When Lightning Strikes with Tom Skilling is sponsored by AT&T and Kraft Miracle Whip Salad Dressing. Get cooking with Miracle Whip.
Want to lower your blood pressure? Have a banana. To prevent a stroke, eat lots of potatoes. You can even lower your cholesterol by snacking on popcorn. Want to know the secrets to really feeling good? Then you need to know what foods can help make you well and what foods can keep you healthy. That's why the editors of Prevention Magazine Health Books ask leading nutritionists for the foods and recipes that can actually prevent and even cure today's most worrisome illnesses and common health problems. Now it's all in one important book, The Healing Foods. I'm Joanne D'Agostino, nutritional consultant to Prevention Magazine Health Books. I'm also a registered nurse, so I know the healing foods can help dramatically improve your health and well-being. Over 450 pages documented by 180 doctors and nutritionists, healing foods that can help prevent over 65 illnesses and conditions from colds to cholesterol, even heart disease and diabetes. You'll learn which tasty soups, delicious pastas, and hearty breads can actually help you lose weight, what fish dishes can help prevent arthritis, even a kind of cheesecake that will help fight osteoporosis. All in the healing foods.
Call now for the healing foods. Try it absolutely free for 21 days, 3 full weeks to learn how you can improve your health with food you like to eat. Then if you choose to keep it, we'll bill you in three easy installments of only $8.99.
And as a free gift, you'll get this special report from Prevention, Young Skin for Life. Over 50 pages of beauty secrets and makeover advice on how to prevent and reverse the signs of aging without cosmetic surgery or artificial makeup.
Remember, you can try the healing foods free for 21 days, and the free guide to young-looking skin is yours to keep.
Call for the healing foods now. And by the way, an apple a day does keep the doctor away.
Call 1-800-382-9800, 1-800-382-9800.
From the beginning of time, lightning has been a source of mystery and fascination. Mythic gods such as Zeus and Thor were depicted holding lightning in their hands. Lightning still holds the same fascination for us today. Scientists believe lightning may have fused together amino acids from which all life on Earth is made, helped form our atmosphere, and introduced humankind to fire. It was the famous strike on Ben Franklin's kite which helped reveal lightning was made up of electricity.
And this television still from Discovery, is it flies across and over Central Africa?
Now viewed from space by our shuttle astronauts, the frequency of lightning is obvious. Lightning flashes across the skies 40 to 100 times per second. But it's here on Earth where lightning's power is seen most clearly. Hernan Cortez was shooting a thunderstorm out his back door when his camera dramatically caught a lightning bolt striking a nearby tree. The bolt literally split the tree down the middle. It is one of the rare times that the destructive power of lightning has been captured on videotape.
Lightning occurs in a thunderstorm because of the separation of huge pools of electrical charges. Near the top of the cloud, where temperatures are below freezing, ice crystals tend to hold on to positive charges, while the raindrops consist mostly of negative charges. There's a positive charge beneath the cloud. Lightning flashes in a thunderstorm cloud between these pools of varied charges, and it also flashes from the base of the cloud to the ground.
But the lightning we see is only a fraction of what a thunderstorm actually produces.
The cloud-to-ground lightning flash is sort of in the minority. The most common type of lightning occurs wholly within the cloud. It's so-called intra-cloud lightning.
Dr. Vince Idoni has investigated lightning for years at the State University of New York in Albany. His unique high-speed close-up films of lightning are remarkable. Here we see lightning as never before. As a rocket is fired into the storm cloud, lightning occurs in millionths of a second. Yet in slow motion, we see it as it really happens. Not a mere flash, but a succession of several white-hot flashes, which happen so fast our eyes are only able to see them as a single flickering stroke. So detailed is Idoni's film, we even see the wind blowing the 4 to 5 inch lightning channel across the frame. Rocket-induced lightning such as this at Cape Canaveral is allowing researchers to study lightning in a controlled environment. Here, scientists attach thin metal wire to specially designed mini rockets. Then, they shoot the rocket directly into an electrically charged storm cloud. The result? Rocket-triggered lightning.
It represents a major advance in techniques and enables us to address certain very basic scientific questions about lightning for the first time.
There are good reasons for doing research here at Cape Canaveral. First, lightning happens more frequently in Florida than just about any other state in the United States. And there's another reason.
And we have liftoff. Liftoff.
In 1987, an Atlas Centaur rocket carrying a communications satellite blasts off during a rainstorm. Seconds later, two lightning bolts flash across the sky. Next, two muffled booms are heard. And the rocket spins out of control.
Booster now going transonic. We have lost telemetry. We don't know quite why yet.
The rocket was hit by lightning and destroyed, costing taxpayers some $161 million. Data from Lightning Research here confirms that rockets and planes can sometimes induce lightning by disturbing a storm's electrical field. Lightning can be destructive in other ways. Lightning strikes cause $50 to $100 million of damage a year to electrical facilities. Watch again in the lower left-hand portion of the screen as an amateur photographer near Englewood, Colorado, captures what appears to be lightning striking electrical equipment. Lightning ignites the majority of forest fires and is responsible for killing farm animals like these, who often huddle under a tree or near a fence. But on a positive note, lightning also produces 20,000 tons of fixed nitrogen, an essential plant nutrient which falls in rainwater.
It's a natural fertilization game, if you will, that goes on, keeps the cycle going to keep the soil in a nutrient-rich condition.
Coming up, how lightning may help us predict when a super tornado is about to strike.
I could win $10,000.
Now you can win $10,000 playing Spell It, the new telephone spelling bee.
Call this number on a touchtone phone. Listen and spell 21 words correctly in 2 minutes or less, and you win $300 instantly.
It's easy and fun to play.
Spell the word money.
M-O-N-E-Y.
That's right.
I won $300.
Grand prize, $10,000. Call 1-900-SPELL-IT. $2.99 a minute. Average call, 5 minutes.
Spell It sponsors literacy programs.
Do you live in fear of the unknown? Will you ever find the true love you've always wanted? Do you want a better life but feel powerless to make changes? Then call the Live Psychic Line. The enlightenment you seek is just a phone call away. Call now. Psychic advisors are waiting to speak with you live and help you find the answers to a better life.
Call toll free 1-800-447-3322. Must be over 18.
Does it seem like all the summer travel bargains have passed you by, leaving you with just two choices? One, pay a fortune to go somewhere. Or two, stay home. Enter Greyhound. We're cutting our summer fares in half. Plan ahead and you'll get half off every seat on every bus to over 1,700 destinations all summer long. So get on the bus and get rolling. Greyhound, half price for the whole summer.
A sandwich isn't a sandwich without Miracle Whip.
Mm-hmm.
But I do something new with Miracle Whip. I cook with it.
Mm-hmm.
Since I love that tangy zip on a ham and cheese sandwich, now I mix Miracle Whip in my cheesy ham casserole. Then I thought, if Miracle Whip is great in chicken salad, why not baste it on baked chicken?
Mm-hmm.
Get cooking with Miracle Whip salad dressing. It's not just for sandwiches anymore.
What's for dessert?
Call 1-800-MIRACLE for great free recipes.
This is a super tornado. It's been captured by an amateur photographer at McConnell Air Force Base near Andover, Kansas. Some scientists believe lightning and electrical energy generated in storms like these may act with a motor effect, actually driving the wind speeds of a tornado higher and increasing their destructive power. It's a decades-old theory, and it's being re-examined by researchers here at the State University of New York at Albany, where lightning is monitored 24 hours a day.
A lightning detection network is now in place using sensors or antennas like these scattered from coast to coast. Antennas able to detect nearly every cloud-to-ground lightning stroke that occurs in the United States as it occurs.
The majority of lightning strikes produced by nature and detected by the system as dots are negatively charged. Researchers, however, find the more powerful and destructive positively charged lightning, represented by plus signs on the screen, show up in unusually large numbers in thunderstorms, which at times go on to produce some of the world's most powerful tornadoes. Researcher Anton Simon believes it is possible the super tornado, which destroyed parts of Plainfield, may have been driven in part by the storm's electrical energy.
In the Plainfield storm, the storm begins producing this predominantly positive cloud-to-ground lightning. However, just prior to the tornado touchdown, the lightning effectively ceased for a while, with only about 1 to 2 flashes occurring per minute. When the tornado actually touched down, these few flashes that were occurring suddenly all became negative. We saw no further positive flashes for quite a while. It appeared that the thunderstorm turned itself upside down electrically, right intimately involved with the tornado formation process, and we really have no idea why.
Skyscrapers like the Sears Tower are frequent targets of lightning strikes. But a lightning protection system channels lightning around the building. Here's how it works. Positive charges gather around the Sears Tower and are pulled skyward by the negatively charged base of the thunderstorm. A dimly lit charge called a step leader lurches earthward. Contact with the positive charges 150 feet above the building then sets off the powerful white-hot return strokes. Though it appears otherwise, the lightning channel never touches the building. Independent Protection Company of Goshen, Indiana is a leading maker of lightning protection systems. Owner Robert Kripe produced this homemade videotape to explain how lightning protection systems work.
So what we'd like to do is show you what happens when lightning actually strikes a building with flammable materials. Now we're going to place some flammable material back on the roof, and we're going to place a lightning protection system on this residence. This lightning protection system in miniature. Now you'll see as lightning strikes that it always goes to a point or to an air terminal.
Lightning protection systems are in place at many golf courses where a significant number of lightning-related deaths and injuries occur. Pro golfer Lee Trevino was hit by lightning in 1975 during the Western Open as he was sitting on his golf bag near a lake.
And what happened is a lightning bolt struck the water, just started bouncing off the water, and hit Jerry Herndon. Now, the sensation that I got was I knew that something was wrong because it just didn't go pow and it was over, you know. I felt it. And I started shaking. And then I started shaking. The next thing I knew, I started hearing a ringing sound in my ear like a ball peen hammer popping. And it's going. And then all of a sudden, the next thing I know, as I look at my feet, now they're up in the air. Now I'm off the ground about this high. And it's got me all stretched out. And at the time, I guess it stops your heartbeat, and I'm gasping for air. I'm sitting there, I'm going. And the next thing I knew is I woke up and I was all doubled up. My left arm was under my body and there were people standing on the green holding towels over me because it was pouring rain and the ambulance was over by the green.
The surest way to avoid being hit by lightning is to get indoors. Inside, stay off the telephone and stay out of the bathtub. Lightning's electricity can travel through wires and plumbing. Outdoors, stay away from trees or other isolated tall objects. Hardtop automobiles or trucks are excellent lightning shelters, providing you don't touch the metal frames. Lightning will flash over the vehicle. It's a myth that rubber tires have anything to do with lightning protection. Stay away from wire fences and water, which can transmit current from a distant lightning strike. Boaters and swimmers in the water are at risk during a lightning storm. Don't gather in groups when you seek shelter from lightning, since lightning can jump from person to person. If you feel an electric charge or your hair stands on end, lightning may be about to strike. Three visitors to Rocky Mountain National Park in Colorado took these pictures of themselves because their hair was standing on end. Only seconds after these photos were taken, all three were hit by lightning. One was killed, the other two were seriously injured. If you suspect lightning is about to strike you, lower yourself immediately into a crouched position and try to make as little contact with the ground as possible. Don't attempt to run away. Coming up, an up-close encounter with lightning as research pilots fly directly into a thunderstorm.
Bam, bam, bam.
I could win $10,000.
Now you can win $10,000 playing Spell It, the new telephone spelling bee.
Call this number on a touchtone phone. Listen and spell 21 words correctly in 2 minutes or less, and you win $300 instantly.
It's easy and fun to play.
Spell the word money.
M-O-N-E-Y.
That's right.
I won $300.
Grand prize, $10,000. Call 1-900-SPELL-IT. $2.99 a minute. Average call, 5 minutes.
Spell It sponsors literacy programs.
Do you ever feel like your life is spinning out of control? You can learn how to take control of your future. Just call the Live Psychic Line now. Psychic advisors are waiting to speak with you live and help you find the answers to a better life. Is there romance in your future? Success? Or money? Call anytime, 24 hours a day. Call now.
Call toll-free, 1-800-869-1212.
Everyone knows Miracle Whip is great on sandwiches.
You right!
But I do something new with Miracle Whip. I cook with it. Since that tangy zip is so ripe for a tuna sandwich, why not use Miracle Whip to zip up my tuna casserole? Then I had another brainstorm. Miracle Whip basted on grilled fish. Even my kids like it. Get cooking with Miracle Whip salad dressing. It's not just for sandwiches anymore.
Call 1-800-MIRACLE for great free recipes.
While some scientists try to unlock the secrets of lightning by studying it from the ground, lightning research is also taking place in the air. The pilot of this specially modified F-106 is flying into a thunderstorm with one purpose: to get his plane hit by lightning as many times as possible. The lightning strikes will be recorded by cameras and scientific instruments on board. Shortly after takeoff, lightning strikes.
Oh, boy. Good, Dallas, I heard three rumbles down the airplane. Bam, bam, bam.
You might think this is a dangerous mission, but lightning is rarely a serious problem for aircraft. Captain James Johnson is an aviation weather expert and has been a Delta airline pilot for 14 years.
Today's airplanes, Tom, are assembled in such a way that should a lightning strike occur, the electricity is transferred throughout the airplane, causing little damage to the airplane itself, and of course, no harm to the passengers riding inside.
Far more fascinating to many pilots is an electrical phenomenon known as St. Elmo's fire, which can sometimes be seen from their windshields as they fly in or near a thunderstorm.
It starts with a glow on the nose of the airplane, and as it builds up towards the cockpit, it gets brighter, and sometimes it's blue, it can be green, or it can be pink, and as it approaches the cockpit, it starts to wave like a flickering neon sign, or it looks almost like a miniature set of northern lights that are flattened up against the windshield, and you can disturb it by moving your finger along, and it'll bend and move, and as the electricity builds, sparks start to jump off the corners of the windshield and form like a spider web netting across the windshield. And it's eerie to see, it's very fascinating to watch, and it's very harmless. It happens all the time, and it's just a fun thing to watch.
Watching lightning, whether from the cockpit or the safety of your own home, is fascinating. Lightning always produces thunder. We just don't always hear the thunder. But thunder is a valuable indicator of how far lightning is from us. The next time you see a flash of lightning, count the number of seconds until you hear the crash of thunder. Every 5 seconds means the lightning is another mile away. The latest weather sensing technologies have helped us unlock many of the secrets of lightning. We've learned a great deal since Ben Franklin's dangerous kite experiment 240 years ago. And you can be sure scientists will continue watching when lightning strikes.